Good evening to all. Today's our topic is how to install Gaia OS in a VMware, either any of the virtual machine. We are going to install the Gaia OS R8010 in any one of the virtual machine, either in a VMware or Oracle VM virtual box, and configuring the first time Gaia configuration in the web UI. Okay, so it's depend upon the time. We will complete the configurations. So we can use any one of the virtual box. Okay, it's a free of cost. You can download from internet. So I am going to use VMware workstation. So in order to install Gaia, you should have a checkpoint OS. That is, the Gaia OS should be available. Okay. So the option is we can go with create a new virtual machine or open a virtual machine. Okay, it's depend upon the file we have. If we have a ISO file as the operating system, we can create that, or if we have a OVA file, that means virtualization file is available, you can import that file into it. As I have a ISO file, I am going to create a new virtual machine. Okay. So while creating a OS installation file for the Gaia OS, we need to prefer custom. Okay, typical in the sense, if the OS is a standardized OS, in the sense Linux OS like Red Hat, Ubuntu or Windows OS, we can go with the typical with the recommended option. Whereas for Gaia installation, we will go with custom. There we can modify our settings based upon our requirements. Okay, so I am selecting the option custom. Okay, so the version I am using is workstation 15.x. That is the new version. If you need any support below of that workstation, you can modify here itself. Workstation 14.x, 12.x, like that you can prefer. As my OS support 15.x, I am going with 15.x. Okay. Here is the file chooser. Okay, which iOS need to be installed. So I am specifying the OS now. By default, it having RHCL server, okay, Red Hat server, but I need to install Gaia. So where it is download means it's in the download file. Okay, I have a version 77.30. Okay, it's no longer going to be have service supported. Most of the environments are migrating to 8030 or 8040. Okay, for our scenario, I am going to go with the 8010. In the later concept, we will see how to migrate from 8010. Okay, I am preferring the OS 8010. Okay, click the open button. Okay, you can see here, could not detect which operating system is the disk image. Okay, so as I told you, it's not a standard OS like Linux or Red Hat or Ubuntu like that. Okay, so you can proceed next. It's a Linux based kernel. Gaia is also a Linux based kernel. So I am preferring Linux. And the version I am preferring is another Linux kernel 64 bit. Okay, so I am going with this option. Click the next button. Okay, here you can specify the virtual name. Okay, the name of the checkpoint firewall. So any name you can give. Okay, I am providing us CP_MGMD. Okay, I am going to configure this checkpoint as a, this training session as a distributed system. There are two architecture is there. One is standalone and another one is distributed. Okay, so we are going to see distributed environment. Let me tell you where we will differentiate the standalone configuration and distributed configuration while configuring the web UI. Okay, so location, where you need to save the file. I am going to my drive, G drive, VMware, the checkpoint. Okay. So I am creating a new folder inside a checkpoint with checkpoint cpng. Click OK. Okay, so here the option is we are specifying the name for our virtual machine. Okay, you can use any name, it's not a host name. Okay, just for your identification name and the location where the data need to be imported, the IOs need to be installed. Okay, click next and the processor selection. Minimum we need 8 processors, so I am selecting number of processor 4 and core per is 2. So totally total processor is 4 is 8 cores. Okay, then the RAM. Okay, minimum requirement for install 8010 is 4 GB. Okay, why? In the sense 8010 supports API. Okay, so automations will be supported by this firewall or the management. For that we need minimum of 4 GB RAM. Okay, by default the API blade will be enabled if the device having 4 GB of RAM. Okay, click the next button. So here we are specifying which network or which adapter need to be elected. Okay, I am going to specify do not use a network connection right now. Okay, end of the time I will show you how we can add a network adapter customize. Okay, depend upon our requirements. Click next. Okay, so we are using the ISO controller as LSI logic, that is the recommended one, and SCSI SCSI. Okay, the hard disk versions. Okay, ID is the older version, SCSI or SATA we can prefer. I am going with SCSI files disk type, and here we are going to create a new virtual machine. Okay, we are not going to use any existing virtual machine. We are going to create a new virtual machine. Okay, so here we can specify the disk space we require. Okay, to install a OS we need 8 GB of RAM, RAM, 8 GB of memory, hard disk memory. This is not a recommended way. We need minimum of 20 GB so that we can utilize for upgradations or any other options. In the sense, copying the file for migration, we can use the file system. Even for executing a local backup, we need some space in the hard disk. Okay, so I am configuring with 20. Okay, and electing here a split virtual disk into multiple files. Okay, this will allocate the space depending on the split virtual disk, not in a specific storage. Okay, single file, and the VMDK file will be created. Click next. Okay, so here is the options you can modify now also. Okay, custom hardware. If you want to modify the memory, you can modify now also. Okay, processor or anything you can modify. Currently I am going to add network adapter custom wise. Okay, so select the option network adapter, click finish. Okay, now here itself also it's coming up with NAT, but I am going with the custom. Okay, specifying the VM host only. So this interface, okay, this Ethernet adapter is going to be a management adapter, so I am specifying as the host only. So yeah, Windows machine will communicate with this management server. Let me show you everything practically. Okay, so I have preferred VMnet 1. If you are changing that, now the configuration has been modified. Just close. Okay, finish. Now the CD drive or the pen drive is ready to boot. Okay, let's power on our device. Let us consider that we have a physical box. Okay, there we are going to install the OS. So far we have loaded the OS. Here after we are proceeding how to install the Gaia OS. Okay. So you have multiple options. Install Gaia on this system. Do not install Gaia. Boot from local drive. Install Gaia on system listed in SK7760. Okay. I am going to use the option install Gaia on this system. Okay, this will start boot up. So here we are going to set the IP address for the adapter. What is the keyboard version we are going to use? As well as we will set the username password for the admin login. Okay, all those things will be configured while that device is booting up. Okay, let me show one by one step further. So the installation is going to be started now. Okay. By asking some questions, we need to perform those. Okay, so it's asking the first question. This process will install the Checkpoint Gaia 8010 operating system and associated applications. So as I told you, some of the applications will be installed by default, like API blades will be enabled, firewall blades. Okay, those all are inbuilt, it's there. Okay, we need to select depend upon our requirement. Do you wish to proceed with the installation? Obviously, yes. Okay, so select okay. So here the as I mentioned, the keyboard type. I'm going with the US keyboard type itself. Okay, click OK. Now the disk space is allocated out of our 20 GB. Okay, 1 GB was utilized for swap, 7 for root, and for the log server it is using 3 GB. Rest of the 8 GB is configured for backup and update. So if you are executing any manual backup inside the local drive, we need some space to perform that. So I'm making all those as default and clicking OK button. Okay, now the password need to be set. Okay, for the username admin. Okay, for the testing purpose I am using the password pcaps ass123. Okay, repeat the same password and click OK. Okay, now we are configuring the management interface. So here we have only one interface. So it's showing us a ETHO0, which is the management interface. You can allocate any IP address which you are going to be within a LAN. Okay, if you are wrongly allocated also, we can modify later. I will show you in the command line. Okay, I am going with the default 192.168.1.1 and the default gateway 192.168.1.254. Even you can delete, not an issue. Okay, so it's up to you. Click OK. Okay, the next stage of the installation process will format all your hard disk. Are you sure want to continue? Obviously, yes. So okay. Okay, so the installation is started. It will take some time, obviously around 5 to 10 minutes of the time. It's depend upon the memory what you have. Okay, so if you are using a slow laptop, okay, it will take more time, whereas how much we are allocating the memory based upon that, this will continue to allocate. Okay, let me pass for the session. We'll join once the installation is started. So the installation of the OS is completed. So we can access the box with the IP:// 192.168.1.1 for first time configuration or for the management using browser web UI, we can use 192.168.1.1 IP address. Okay, as the installation is completed, okay, it is asking for a reboot. Okay, we can click OK button. Okay, that's reboot button. Okay, this will reboot the Checkpoint OS. So now the device is booting up with the OS which we have installed, Gaia 8.0.10. Okay, starting the system. In the meanwhile, I am validating the Windows 8 I have. Windows OS, Windows 8 is my console machine I am going to use to configure the web UI. Okay, let me see the settings here. So edit virtual machines. So that is also already configured on the custom VM VMnet one. So both are in the same network adapter so that I can communicate from the Windows machine to the management server. Okay, so I am powering up the machine parallelly. This will take some time to start the system. So once the device is booted up, it will ask for your username and password. For the testing purpose, we are using the same username, which is admin, and the password is pass123. Okay. So once login, we have in the command line interaction, we have two modes. One is considered as glitch mode, and another one is expert mode. Okay. Let me show you all one by one. Still the Windows machine also booting up, so boot on progress. Okay, the device is booted up. Okay, it is asking for the login. So as I specified, the login username is admin. Okay, sorry. The username is admin, and the password I have utilized is pass123. Okay, so it is specifying that in order to configure your system, please access the web UI and finish the first time wizard. Okay, that represents we need to be access the web UI using the IP address https://192.168.1.1 and decided either it is a standalone or distributed configured server. Okay, so this is considered as the glitch mode. Okay, the symbol greater than represents glitch mode. Here we can execute some commands. Okay, for example, if you want to check the interface, the command is show interface. Okay, so interface space, you can specify the specific interface you need to check. Okay, in our case, we have only one interface, that is ETHO0. Okay, so it's coming up like this. So if you are need any support, you can use the tab button. Okay, so there are two interfaces are there, one is ETHO0 and one is loopback0. Okay, so we if you need to check the IP address configured for the ETHO0, we can use E and press the tab button. Okay, so here we can specify 192.168.1.1 is the IP address configured with the subnet mask of 255.255.255.0, that is the CIDR value 24. Okay, let me validate what is the IP configured on the Windows device. It's a bit slow. Okay, Windows Shade is also loaded successfully. Let us check what is IP configured on the Windows 8. Okay, depend upon the IP address configured here, we can modify in the management. Either we need to modify the management side or we need to modify the Windows side. Okay, so as I told you, I will let you know how to configure the IP address in the command line. Okay, I am going to show you that. So it's quite a bit slow. So I have opened the command prompt to validate the IP address. Okay, so the command is ipconfig. So here also we have set 192.168.1 network. Okay, so definitely we can able to ping. Let us ping validate the ping test. Okay, ping 192.168.1.1 is the IP address port figure. Okay, so from the client machine, that is the Windows machine, I can able to access the management server. Okay, whatever, maybe either it's a management or the gateway that is not yet decided. So we can able to ping from Windows machine to the Gaia OS. Okay, let us validate from the management whether the Windows 8 machine is reachable. Okay, ping 192.168.1.10 is IP. 192.168.1.10. Okay, you may see drop. Okay, currently we are seeing drop because Windows side the defender may be on. Okay, so Windows firewall is dropping the connections from the Gaia OS to the Windows OS, whereas from the Windows where we can able to access. So let us open a web browser to configure the first time configuration wizard. So we have completed the ping test, which means from the Windows machine we can able to access the Gaia OS. Okay, so as my Chrome have hung, I am utilizing Internet Explorer. Okay, so what is the management IP? Is https://192.168.1.1. okay, that is the management IP of our Gaia OS. Okay, so it's an internal certificate. Okay, it's throwing an internal certificate error. Let's proceed further. So continue to the website. Okay, it will ask for your admin name and password. So the username is, we have admin, and the password we are using is pcaps ass123. Okay, the same username and password which we utilize to log in to the command line. It will open the first time configuration wizard for us to configure the OS either as a management server or a gateway or a domain controller. It depends upon that, or we can configure the management server and gateway in a single box. That architecture is called a standalone architecture. Okay, so it's welcoming us to configure the checkpoint first time configuration wizard. Click the next button. Okay, it will ask for continue with the 8010 configuration. Yes, click next. Andy, okay, so the only one Etho interface is available. So we have already configured with the management IP 192.168.1.1. Okay, if we have multiple Ethernet adapters, while clicking next, we can configure each and every adapters. There's other option also, I told you, in the command line itself, we can configure the Ethernet interface. Okay, we'll see while configuring the gateways. Okay, click the next button. And it is asking for the gate host name. I am going to configure the host name as MGMT, and the domain name is optional. Primary DNS server, we can use the public DNS server 8.8.8.8, which is the Google DNS server. Click next. Okay, and the time zone is configured for our IST time zone. Okay, so the time is 8:39 and May 1st. Okay, we are not going to do any changes. If in a real time we have a NTP server, network time protocol server, okay, we can use the NTP server, specify the NTP server name and etc. So currently I am going to go with my manual configuration. Click next. Okay, so here is the position where we need to select either this is a multi-domain server, a MDS server, or it's a security gateway or security management. Okay, if you want to promote this OS as a multi-domain server, in the sense the domain which can handle multiple number of domains, okay, in a single global properties we can push multiple number of domains. Okay, for that we can create multiple domain. So I am talking about the management and the gateway, so I am specifying the security gateway and management. Okay, so here is the option, either to configure as a standalone box or a distributed environment. Okay, so as I specified, we are going with the distributed environment. If you are specifying these options and clicking this, that would be the standalone configuration. Okay, whereas I am going to configure this as the only the management server, so I have preferred security management. Okay, click the next button. So if you want to set the admin password, you need to create a new username or password. You can define here, whereas I am sticking with the same admin and the password. Okay, click the next button. Okay, and here specifying what are the IPs which can manage our management. Okay, you can restrict based upon your required environment. As of all, it's a test environment, I am specifying any IPs. Okay, so the difference here is, if you are selected the security gateways, if you are selected the security gateway, then you need to configure the SIC, secure internal communication. So the IP address will be the DHCP or not? No. Okay, then you will specify SIC, secure internal communication. Whereas we are configuring secure management, in that case who all are eligible to access the management server? So we need to set the IP address to manage. Here I am specifying any IP can manage my management server. Click next. Okay, finish button. This will perform the configuration process. Once the process is completed, it will reboot the box again. Okay, so click yes. Okay, so it is verifying the configuration. Once verification is completed, then security, it will promote it as a security management. Then it will install the compatibility packages. Final configuration will be performed. This will take some time. Okay, once this completed, we will come back. So guys, it's completed the finalizing configurations and completed the configuration. Okay, so click the OK button. So the first time configuration is successfully completed. Now it's loading to the box. Management server as it's a distributed environment, it's taking some time. Okay, let us wait. Okay, so the configuration is completed and the device is come up with the server. Okay, if you don't have a smart console on your machine, you can download from here. Okay, so this is the application which allows us to manage the management from the console box. Okay, so the Windows 8 box is the console box, whereas the CPMGMT is the management. With the GUI of this software, we can able to manage the management server. Okay, unable connect. Okay, but I have downloaded this and installed already. So if you are seeing my desktop, you can see the application smart console which is already installed for 8010. Okay, So let us go to the management. Okay, actually, as I specified, we are in the expert mode. There are two modes, cliche and the expert mode. Okay, we'll update these terms in the further. Hope so far, whatever we have seen is informative for you.